maximizing individual feed intake in lactating sows, providing them with the right start. In this video, we will go through the main areas to look at from pre-farrow up to day 7 of lactation to support individual feed intake. Implementation of a comprehensive sow care program focusing on prevention, prompt identification of sow care needs, and individualized interventions in early lactation should be a top priority in your sow farm. In the following slides are sow care management recommendations for pre-farrowing. Keeping sows in good condition throughout gestation is imperative. Heavy sows eat less in lactation than ideal body condition sows. We need to flag and treat the females with early identification of compromised hoof integrity or structure issues, and also early wean them if necessary. Place all gilts together when loading the farrowing room. They need extra attention for water and feed training pre-farrow. It is important to train your gilts before they farrow. Make sure they know how to drink and where to drink within 24 hours from loading the farrowing room. Check the water nipple flows daily. They should be on a 2 liter per minute range. Stand the sows up twice a day and touch the water nipple to stimulate water intake. Train your gilts pre-farrow on full feed access as well when using automated full feeders. Touch and show them how to activate the mechanism to access the feed. The sows should have unrestricted access to fresh feed, even from 2 to 3 days prior farrowing, when arriving in the right body condition. And if hand feeding, increase frequency of feeding to 2 to 3 times per day, providing the same amount given in gestation. In the following slides are sow care management recommendations at farrowing. The temperature at farrowing is recommended to be between 72 and 74 degrees Fahrenheit. Deep pit rooms are 74 to 76 degrees Fahrenheit. Then gradually drop the room temperature to 66 to 68 degrees Fahrenheit by 7 to 10 days or before if the conditions make it necessary. Attend and monitor 100% of the sows properly when the staff is on. The goal is to minimize having sows delivering pigs longer than 5 hours. Smooth and quick postpartum recovery is quick to maximize water and feed intake from day one. It is important to identify sows within the first 24 hours of farrowing that show discomfort. Sows laying down on their bellies and not letting piglets nurse is an early sign that intervention is required. Good sow nursing behavior is a sign that the pre-farrow preparation was a success and the sow will have a faster farrowing recovery time. In the following slides are sow care management recommendations post-farrowing. Check sows' rectal temperature 24 hours after farrowing and check for sows with mastitis and edema. Also check for sows that did not eat or drink in the first 24 hours. Minimize piglet movement at fostering while keeping litter integrity in an 85% range. Any piglet added into a litter will create a disruption that will impact both piglet suckling, their well-being, and the sow's nursing comfort. It's important to keep the piglet's early life scours under control. Sick piglets will not nurse as much, causing milk reduction in the sow. That will impact negatively on the sow's well-being and appetite. Reduce the number of pig handling and processing events as much as you can. Any stress events on litters could impact the individual's feed intake in the subsequent 12 to 24 hours. Stand the sows up at least twice a day, especially the P1s. This is also a good opportunity to check legs and for lameness on sows and to stimulate their appetite. Early identification of sows that are capable of eating more is important. Empty feeders in the morning is definitely a red flag. As an empty feeder in the morning is a red flag, a full feeder in the morning is a red flag as well. Identify those sows that have not eaten or drank from the day before. Daily adjustments in feeders and daily removal of wet and spoiled feed will help to keep the sows eating. Daily fresh feed allowance is key. It is also very important to monitor the sow's water intake on a daily basis. In this photo, with the cobwebs on the water nipple, identifies that that sow has not drank from that water nipple. These are general recommendations, and we encourage the production staff to follow their farm protocols. Farms should have procedures created and approved by their production management head.